For the past 50 days, I've been building LEGO cars, and here are some highlights of the past 50 days of things I've done. On day 2, I built this custom alternative build Porsche 911, and I talked about it. Although I've changed out the tires, everything is the same from the instructions, and it's a really cool build. Although fragile, it definitely looks good on the shelf. Then on day 4, I battled Ferrari versus Lamborghini in an epic showdown. It was a battle between style, speed, interior, demand, and it was a close one. You should check it out and see the results. On day 8, I built my very first Speed Champions. I've never touched the bricks before to make my own, and this was my first attempt. Although it got upgraded in a later video I'll talk about soon, this was definitely a fun video, and I added all sorts of my own details, including this beautiful rear view. But then on day 9, we compared sizes, working our way from small LEGO Speed Champions, like the Lamborghini, up to the biggest LEGO Speed Champions, like the Mercedes G-Wagon. Then on day 11, we talked about 100 Speed Champions details, like the fact that the 4 GT's doors wiggle. On day 14, we modded 3 cars, which included my original Speed Champions, and I added doors to it, as well as turning a Solus GT black and white, which is really cool. Then on day 17, I built my second alternative build of this series, which is a Maserati MC20 with the pieces of Ferrari F40, which is really cool and one of my favorite things I've done so far in these past 20 days. And on day 18, it was a huge deal because I assembled all 50 of my LEGO Speed Champions, having just built the Maserati MC20 being my 50th and enjoying the sight to see all my Speed Champions together. I surprised my parents with their car built out of LEGO. Jumping straight to day 23, we talked about how there's some brands that LEGO's yet to make in Speed Champions form, like Maserati with this MC20 or a Range Rover. I don't know where the wheels went, don't ask me. Then on day 24, we weaponized LEGO Speed Champions, which ended up with us weaponizing a James Bond car with this giant cannon from Star Wars. And then on day 25, we put a giant engine in the back of our Lotus. This Lotus is supposed to be an electric car, well, not anymore. Day 26 was a versus battle between the German motor car brands BMW and Mercedes. Day 27 entails me upgrading my Corvette by making it have a cooler fin and smoothing out the car. Then on day 29, I built my own Porsche 911 out of the old 6-stud wide version with my own customized upgrades. On day 33, I simulated the life of a LEGO car owner, working from a small go-kart to the famous McLaren F1, progressing through the character's life. On day 34, I played it dangerous with law firms by upgrading 4 Ferraris, and this was the best one with this giant wing on it, although you may think it's a little silly. Then on day 36, we sized things up by getting this giant Porsche 911, and it turned out to be quite the task. It wasn't a whole lot of fun to build, and the video didn't do super well. Then on day 38, we looked at all sorts of car brands that I owned in my LEGO collection, especially wild ones like Koenigsegg and Pagani. After we went big with the 911, we went small with these tiny little cars, and we built them all throughout a fun little video about building tiny cars. On day 47, I wide-bodied this Porsche 911, and it was a ton of fun. It's one of my favorite cars in my collection now. Then I built a LEGO Speed Champions drag racer, and we took it to the max. Well, now we're 50 days in, and I don't plan on stopping yet, and it's been a lot of fun. I can't wait to see what happens in the next 50.